Morning students, how are you? Hope you are happy and healthy. In our previous sessions we discussed various techniques to improve English fluency, then the being of extrovertness, the importance of frankness, and the guessing techniques. All those were discussed. In this class we are going to discuss on a term, team spirit. Dear student, if you see any advertisement in a newspaper, in any job classified in a newspaper for any position in a company, generally they mention the qualification of a candidate, experience of a candidate. Your candidate must be a graduate, your candidate must have got some experience, your candidate must have good communication skills, and your candidate must have a team spirit. What does it mean? Okay, no problem. That is, after 3 years you are going to get your degree, and through practice you are going to enhance your English fluency, and you are getting some experience also by doing part-time jobs. That's a different topic, we shall discuss later. Okay, what is the team spirit? How to acquire it? As I already told you that nowadays in any multinational company the entry level job would be to act as a team member or a team leader. You have to work with a team, or you have to act as a team member or as a team leader. One thing remember, doing work is very easy, but getting work is a tough task. If some job is given to you, you can do it easily. If you are assigned a work, if you are in a position to get work from others, it is not an easy task. Here, effective communication plays a vital role. So, teamwork is nothing but working in a team. Work with all your team members, or if you are a team leader, get work from your team members. It is a tough task. Unless otherwise, if you are an extrovert, what does it mean? Extrovert, last class we discussed. Extrovert is a man, a person, one who is expressive. One who expresses his ideas freely and frankly, extrovert. And the antonym is? Yes, introvert. I told you, you never be an introvert. It is very dangerous attitude. It is not a good attitude. So you have to be an extrovert. What are the qualities of an extrovert? You must be outspoken, you must be bold, you must be broad-minded, right? So you must ready to accept the views of others, and you must be express your views to others. These are all the traits of extroverts. Okay, how to acquire this skill? While you study, how to acquire this? Very first thing is that to be an extrovert, you must overcome your fear. You must overcome your fear. You must overcome your stage fear. You must know how to face the audience. See, talking to audience is an art. Oratorical skill is an art. How to develop it? Very simple. Participate in all type of competitions which is conducted in our college. For example, after this pandemic is over, when you visit our campus, you will have more opportunities to express your ideas. For example, each and every department in our college conducts competitions. Whenever competition takes place, you must participate in it. You must develop the habit of looking all the notice boards, irrespective of the departments. Each and every department conducts an elocution competition, essay writing competition, quiz competition, very often. What you have to do is, whatever the department, whether it is a language department or arts department or science department, whatever it is, you just to participate in the competitions. You must give your name. You must participate, and very particularly you must participate in elocution competitions, oratorical competitions. You must participate in debates. Generally our boys don't do this. My humble advice to you is, do not miss the opportunity. You must participate in all type of competitions. And generally, you know what we do, again the fear factor spoils our boys' ideas. That is, if I participate, if I lose, what will happen? Don't worry, participation is a big thing. Participation is a primary task. Whether you win a prize or not, that is secondary. Do not bother about winning. But participating must be your main objective. Just to participate it. Because you will get a chance to face the audience. Who are the audience? That is the students of our college will be your audience. You can develop the art of speaking. See, if you keep on participating in all type of competitions, you can develop the confidence so that you can easily win the group discussion. Again, a new term is coming, group discussion. What does it mean? Group discussion. You might have heard before it. That is, in any multinational company, if you go for an interview, your selection procedure begins with group discussion. It is called as GD round. See, after receiving your resume, what they would do, they ask you to sit in a semicircle round. They divide the groups into 10 or 12 groups. Each group comprises 10 boys. And some personnel from that company enter into a room and he would give you a topic. Some general topics will be given. On that topic you have to speak, on that topic you have to discuss on that topic for 15 minutes with your co-fellows. So all other candidates are sitting beside you, right? Maybe they are unknown, maybe they are known, whatever may be that, but the general topic will be given on the spot. On that topic you have to discuss on 15 minutes. In that 15 minutes, what they would observe, what they do, what they observe is, they would look at your attitude, that is, how you agree with others, how you disagree with others, how you clarify your doubts, how you verify others' views, how you persuade others. All those things they observe from you, how you do it, and who is taking initiative, who is asking questions, how you are answering the questions, how you are responding to others. All those things they observe within 15 minutes. They never disturb you. They simply, you know, stand in a corner of that room and they simply look at your attitude, that how you would discuss. Are you really effective in your communication? How polite you are? How considerate you are? How adjustable you are? All those qualities they observe within 15 minutes. At the end of that round, they would simply call the numbers, that is, those who think that they are suitable. They select 3 or 4 candidates from each batch and they retain them, and rest of the candidates will be said goodbye. They would say goodbye to rest of the fellows. This is the first round. You have to get through the first round, group discussion round. Then personal interview. So likewise, you know, after getting through the 3 or 4 rounds, only the final round takes place. That is, sometimes it is called as HR round. You have to appear for a HR round. For that, you must be prepared. For what they judge in your group discussion round, very simple, that is the term I told you, that team spirit. Whether you have the team spirit or not. So what they want to know, will you capable to work with a team or not? This is how they select you. So if you participate in all sort of competitions, and particularly elocution competitions and essay writing competition and debate competition, wherever it takes place, whether it is intercollegiate competition or intracollegiate competition, whenever the competition events takes place, just go ahead and register your name. Whether it is Tamil elocution competition or English elocution competition or Urdu elocution competition, whatever it may be, that just to participate. Even you may not get prize, do not worry about it. Never bother about the winning of a competition. Participating itself is, you know, it is something like a good sign. If you do so, you can develop team spirit. You can develop communication skills. This is the first point. And the second point is that the another way of developing team spirit is that inside the classroom, when your offline class begins, what you have to do is very, you must not be reserved. Usually our boys, they simply, what they do, they always maintain silence inside the classroom. That is one of the, that is the bad habit. I am very sorry to tell you that. That is, that had been nurtured by our schools. It is from first standard onwards, what the teachers would do is, they warn our boys to keep quiet. Silence. Pin drop silence. See, actually I hate that phrase, pin drop silence. What is happening? That silence will make you silent forever. That is not good. Particularly, that is language classes must be noisy. Classes must be noisy. Some discussion must take place. And generally, what is happening, even, at the schools, at colleges, if a class is very silent, because everyone thinks that the teacher is a very highly disciplined fellow, that he keeps all the students silence. I don't think it is good. So inside the classroom, how you would be? You must ask questions. Asking question is a very good habit. If you ask question, you can get rid of the fear. Ask doubts. Ask questions. Agree with your teachers. Even you can disagree with your teachers. If your teacher asks a question, if you know the answer, say yes. If you don't know the answer, say no boldly. Because generally our boys think that saying no, what my teacher think. If I say no, my teacher think that I am a dullard. I don't know anything. And my friends should laugh at me. No, say no boldly. Do you know what is it mean? No means? Do you know? No means? Next opportunity. No means? Next opportunity. When you say no, you know the secret of saying no. When you say no, you learn something new. Saying yes is very easy, but if you say no, you are a great man. Say confidently, sir, I don't know. Nothing wrong in it. Saying no is not an offense. You are not a criminal. Say no boldly. If you know the answer, say that boldly. Ask two questions. When you ask questions, you learn something new. The class would be very competitive. You can create a very challenging atmosphere. You get an opportunity to interact with your teachers. If you keep on, maintaining silence inside the classroom, it is look like a graveyard. I am very sorry to say this. It looks like a graveyard. Why this silence? Ask questions, learn something new, clarify your doubts. You must discuss inside the classroom. See, because these ideas paves way to develop your team spirit. Participate in NSS. participate in NCC, participate in various activities of our college, participate in all the functions which takes place in our college, because we always invite great personalities from other states. Listen to their speeches, listen how they speak, whether it is conducted by Tamil department or English department or Urdu department, whatever the department may be, that participate in it. Develop the habit of taking notes. See, what will happen, these are all the things that decides your career, apart from your academic performance. Apart from your degree certificates, these things will help you to get a good job. So, this is the only way to develop your team spirit. If you have this team spirit, you can win an interview. See, dear students, in this session, I would like to tell you one thing. I make it clear that my objective is, because I am not going to teach you anything new. Already you are familiar with English language. Already you have got a very good vocabulary. I know that, I believe you that all of you have got enough words. You have got enough vocabulary power to speak and write. Do you agree with me? Yes. But the thing is, why majority of our boys are jobless? Because they merely think that only getting degree is enough. Not enough. See, always think that what the job market expects from you. You have to mentally prepare for that. That is the very purpose of your degree. What's the very purpose of your degree? To be at home? No. People insult you. You must work in a company. You must go out. You must venture into the real world. You must step into a risk zone. From comfort zone. Again, two new words. What is comfort zone? And what is risk zone? What is comfort zone? See? Comfort zone? Risk zone. Now you are in a comfort zone. Now you are in a comfort zone. Comfort zone, what does it mean? My house, my relatives, my friends, my parents, my hometown, my streets. You are very, very happy. This is your comfort zone. This is your comfort zone. Dear friends, you are very happy because you are in a comfort zone. But do you know one thing? In a comfort zone, rate of success is very low. But you have to be prepared for risk zone. What does it mean? Risk zone, new place, new atmosphere. Everything is new. A place is new. A company is new. All the people, those who are working in a company, are new. Everything, very new atmosphere, very new world. Risk zone. In a risk zone, the success rate is high. See, after completing your graduation or post-graduation, you are going to be at home. You are going to be in your native place. How can you touch the heights of your life? only if you go out. Only if you go out. Now you are in a cocoon. You must come out of your cocoon so that you can enjoy a new life of your life. As long as you are in a cocoon, no one knows who are you. No one knows what is inside that cocoon. When you come out, then only you know the world will realize the real potentialities of your personality. That is the risk zone. In a risk zone, it is very challenging. If you get job in a company, what you have to do? You have to move with new people. You have to work in a new atmosphere. You have to search for your accommodation. You have to adjust everything. You are meeting a different type of people. Each and every, that is a man you are meeting is distinct in his nature. So be prepared for risk zone. In that risk zone will tell you who you are. After all, you know, you have to step into a different world after your graduation. So these 3 years you will get 3 years to design yourself. You have to design your life. You have to design your life. These 3 years are going to add new meaning to your life. So be ready for risk. Okay. And another one thing is that in previous class I just told about an effective communication. If you want to be a very good team member or if you want to be a good team leader, your communication must be effective. Again, I would like to recall, I would like to remind you that you need not to confuse over the term effective communication. See, as I already told you that perfect communication is a misnomer. It is a misconception. Remove that word from your brain. What is the meaning of effective communication? If your opponent understands your conversation, then your communication is an effective communication. Okay? Yes. What's that? See, for example, if someone says something to you, or you just imagine that if some person is giving you wrong information, how you have to respond him? You have to respond him that, friend, I think you are wrong. This is the one way of responding. Another way, shut up your mouth, you don't know anything, you are wrong. See, in both sentences, grammatically you are using grammatically correct sentences. But the first one has got a polite tone. But the second one sometimes hurt the feeling of your opponent. So you must speak politely. There is one, a special term is there in a multinational company to develop the name, those habits with some special name. We shall discuss many things in our next class. Thank you so much.